Hello and welcome back. A number of people want to know how to copy data of this type without the blank cells here. That means this data should not be copied to sheet 2. And of course the sheet 2 has the same headers as the sheet 1. Well, we can do this quickly and easily using VBA. So we go to the Developer tab, Visual Basic, Insert, Module. We write our subroutine or macro name, copy non-blank data, define a few variables, so dim e row as long, last row as long, and I as long. Now we will define the last row, and most of us know how to do this. This has been documented in many earlier videos. So last row refers to the last row used in sheet 1. That is the sheet from which we want to copy the data and bring it to sheet 2. So last row will be sheet 1 dot cells rows dot count. That gives us our row index, and this is our column index, 1 dot end xl up dot row. It says an error here because I forgot the, not forgot, instead of a bracket or parenthesis I typed a zero. So now the last row has been defined. We will start our looping process. So for I, assign the value 2 to last row, because in our first row we have the header. So if sheet 1 dot cells I comma 1, that is our column 1 and row I, if that is not blank, then we wish to do a few things. Like for example, we wish to copy the two column data. So sheets, sheet 1, and you will notice I'm writing the code exactly as we would do it step by step. So here I've forgotten a quote, dot range. Now we use the range property with the cells property to copy only the data that we need. So we need the data from row I and column 1 and row I and column 2. So that is what we wish to copy. So dot copy. Now once we have copied that data, we will go to sheet 2. So we will say sheets, sheet 2 dot activate. And once we are in sheet 2, we will go to the first blank row where we can paste our data. So our first blank row is the E row, or you could have also called it blank row, and that is in sheet 2 dot cells rows dot count. That gives us our row index comma 1, that gives us our column index, dot end xl up dot offset by one row, we remain in the same column, therefore 0.row. And of course you would have quickly noticed that the difference between the last row and the E row is just the offset part. That means we find the last row and we offset it by one row and go down where we are going to paste our data. Now what we will do, we will say active sheet dot paste, and the paste destination, so destination colon equals to sheet 2 dot range. We use again the range property with the cells property, so cells E row, that will be our next blank row in sheet 1 and in column 1, and we will select the cells in the E row and column 2, the data is going to be pasted in these cells. So we don't need to copy the complete row and paste it, because that will make the macro slower. Okay, and now we have to go back to sheet 1 and then do the same process again. So we will say sheet 1 dot activate. So we are here, and because we started with an if, so we will end if, and our loop start with for, so we will say next or next I to make it more accurate. And once this is done, we also wish to remove the ant-like selection structure for the copy and paste by writing this single line of code, application dot cut copy mode as false. Okay, so our code is complete. Let me just arrange this so that you can see it thoroughly. Still not visible. Well, we can reduce this a little bit more, and there you can see most of the code. Okay, now we will save this, click on the run button. Something happened. We'll go to our Excel worksheet. This is our data in sheet 1, because we've come back, and in sheet 2, you see, we have removed the blank areas and got our data nicely in sheet 2. Okay, now we can delete this for the time being, because I wish to make the automation complete. So we'll go to the developer tab. Insert, we'll insert a command button here, click and drag, so we get a button, and immediately we get a new window which says assign macro. That means on this button, or for that button, which macro do you want to assign? We'll assign this one, the one we created just now, and we'll say okay. We'll just click inside this, and we will say copy non-blank data to sheet 2. Okay, we can increase the size of this button a little bit. We'll click outside. The moment we go here, you get a hand. So if you click on this, the transfer to sheet 2 will take place. There it is. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.